if we're out in front of our car and we're confronting a person, you know, we just roll up onto a scene and we've got someone that's a little verbally irate or something like that, and all of a sudden they take to attacking us, that's when we have the option on our belts, we have these little remote controls. And what it does, it allows this back door, when I hit the button as needed, the back door will automatically pop open, and out comes my dog to my assistance. We only train on this door. When we get our dog normally out for a break or just to go home, they get out the other side of the car. Anytime this door opens, the dog knows it's time to work.
Several years back, we had a local gang in the next city over had a shootout. And one gang member shoots the other gang member, and neither one of them are dead at this point. They both are brought to our emergency room. So now we have both families and friends of these rival gangs coming to our emergency room. And it's like 2 or 3 in the morning, and it's a pretty busy evening for us. And we have what's called the SMASH team here, which is a Sheriff's Department Special Task Force for gang enforcement. Well, we were trying to keep them in check outside the emergency room. They were wanting to fight with each other there. They were wanting to fight with our staff. They wanted to get back to see their friends who they're trying to work on. Well, we had a doctor come out and announce that one of the gang members was dead. And they just kind of erupted in this ball of fury. They were really, really angry. They started pulling apart doors and climbing over counters and pretty much scared everybody pretty bad. The sheriff's department was doing all they could to keep them in check. We had a few make it through their barrier and into the emergency room. My canine partner and I at the time had just happened to come around the corner making our way to the front when they had pried open the double doors to the emergency room. And you can't really train for this. You can train for the apprehension and everything else, but when they came through that door, my dog stood up on all fours, this hair stood up on the back of his neck, and this deep bellowing growl like I've never heard before just came out of his throat. And these gang member guys just hit the wall, boom, like parting the Red Sea.
I think a lot of people see that, and they see the dogs, and you know, they kind of know, you know what, I'm cool because Cairo's here and he's going to keep me safe.
When we've had an extremely rough day or stressful day, we've just had to wrestle someone to the ground, or we've had to chase down a car burglar or something like that, that 5 or 10 minutes can just heighten your adrenaline for the day, and you're just mentally wears you out, and it is draining and it's taxing on your dog. One of the things we really enjoy doing is we'll go and just make our visiting rounds, our normal rounds that we do throughout the day. But what happens with that is it's a whole nother world that we never expected when we started doing this. It's an added benefit for us. It's a bonus. It's therapy almost. We get to go in and we're just doing our normal patrol, foot patrol through the hospital, but we end up visiting patients and nursing staff and physicians and visitors. And to see their faces light up and the change in them when we're walking in a room and here's this child that's been in here for 3 or 4 months with leukemia and they've been treated for radiation and they just don't want to get out of bed and their parents are tired and you know, they've just been here a long time, and we'll come into the room and our dogs will hop right up onto the bed and their faces light up and there's renewed energy. And it's almost a selfish thing on our part because then the energy flows right through us. And it's just, it lightens your whole day. I can go home at the end of the day and just have happy thoughts and, oh yeah, my wife wants to hear about my day. Well, we chased this bad guy and we did this, but we went up to this kid that hadn't been out of the hospital in 3 or 4 months and you should have seen his face light up and their parents' face light up. We had an experience one time, and this is one of my most memorable, is we walked into a rehab room, and we were just doing a normal thing. We hadn't been requested or anything, and we walked into this room, and there was this, I think she was about 4 or 5 year old little girl sitting on this bed, and a couple of therapists next to her, and grandma and mom behind her. So we walked in, and I was like, hey, how's everybody doing? And we stopped and talked to one kid, and then this another child, and my dog hopped up into this bed off to the side. It's like a lower platform. And just laid down right next to this little girl. And she just turned, not a whole lot of emotion, but a little bit, and she just said, a doggy! And I was like, that's right, it's a doggy. And she started petting and hugging it. And I look up and the nurses are crying, and the mother's crying, and the grandmother's crying, and I'm thinking, what's the matter? Do you want me to leave? Did I do something wrong? And apparently, this child had just had brain surgery about 2 weeks before and spoke normally before and hadn't spoken since. And so, next thing you know, we are being called up on a daily basis to increase this child's therapy. And I mean, how do you top that? You just don't top that. That is just an experience that you never be able to get anywhere else.
The kids just have a blast because it takes their worries away because it's something aside from their normal day of medication and being sick and not being able to go home, watching the same things at home, and then, you know, there's this new life thing that comes and says hello and
it perks them up.
Yeah, kids love it. Kids love it.